What up YouTube, Spike Rod here with another video, and today I'm going to share something with you that I've never shared on this channel before. I believe in the concept of death of the author. Now, for those of you who don't know what death of the author is, it is a concept based on the essay of the same name written by Roland Barthes. The basic gist of it is that any reader's interpretation of a particular work of fiction is no more or less valid than the author's interpretation. This gained popularity within postmodernism, which was highly critical of the Enlightenment era. Now, I'm not some sort of postmodernist or anything like that. I think the Enlightenment era and postmodernism both have merit as philosophies. And I also don't want to make this video too complicated by going into these philosophies. I just want to stick to why I believe death of the author has much more merit than authorial intent. There are several reasons. Also, keep in mind, death of the author does not just apply to literature. It can very well apply to any medium, including movies, music, and even video games. Okay, the first reason why is because the author is often unavailable or unwilling to give you the intention of every single part that goes into his work or her work. It would honestly be a huge fucking waste of time to find every single author of a work and try to get them to explain their intentions. Many of them may be dead or live in areas that I don't live in, or just like their privacy. I also may not like what I find. In fact, many of them would just say, "What do you think it means?" As a matter of fact, Benjamin Burnley, you know, the frontman of Breaking Benjamin, has even stated that he intentionally keeps the writing in his lyrics vague so that people can interpret his lyrics for themselves. I want to direct you to something I said previously, and that's, I may not like what I find. What I mean by that is, the answer I do get might not make sense in terms of what is actually being said or written, or just not really be that fascinating. That might just not make me like it anymore. That is a risk that is really not worth taking. What was the intention of every scene and event that happened in the novel The Lords of Discipline or the movie Taxi Driver? That is a question that I don't have the answer to. But it's also a question that I don't need the answer to, nor do I really want to try and find it. The mystery of it is more engaging than the answer. Another reason is that it can give confidence in yourself and your interpretations of a work. I think one of the reasons why the art of storytelling has lasted as long as it has is because it speaks to everybody differently. I have more often than not have had interpretations of novels, movies, and music that differ from many others. I don't think that I'm right and they're wrong. I just don't interpret it in the way that they do. They may have their reasons for interpreting it that way, but I have mine as well. There was an article on Snake from Escape from New York and Escape from LA that said Snake hates America. I don't think Snake hates America. I think he just hates the people running it and the state that it's in. And you know, judging by what it's become, he has every reason to hate both. While there may be evidence to support their theory, There is also evidence to support my theory, because the door is just left open to those possibilities. I mean, Snake doesn't really talk that much anyway, so there's a lot you could derive from it. That goes for many characters who are not very vocal. That's not to say that I've never agreed with the author's interpretation more than other people. I interpret The Lord of the Rings not to be an allegory for World War II, which is what J.R.R. Tolkien intended it to be. Many people see Angel Cop as anti-American when it was actually meant to be highly critical of the Japanese government. And those themes were only added in because Ichiro Itano just kind of gave up, and I think that definitely does come through in that anime. If you want a bizarre example, I disagreed with the nostalgia critic's take on Lola Bunny and sided more with the people who created her's interpretation. But then you have movies like Saving Private Ryan, which people are split on its stance on war in general. I've not seen it enough to make my judgment, but my point is that I have my own interpretations of any piece of art that I've seen, and I have good reasons for having them. Now, obviously, you have to back your interpretation up with what actually happens in the work. You can't just throw canonicity out. But I think what the essay is trying to argue is not that every person's interpretation is right. It's that there is no objectively right or wrong interpretation of a work. Sure, there have been times when there's really no other way to interpret some works of art, but that's because the symbolism within that particular piece of art was obvious. Sorry, got a text. I'll check it later. But there are actually way more pieces of art that leave room for interpretation. The more room you leave, the more we can draw meaning out of something. Pieces of text, or by extension art, have multiple meanings and they will differ from every reader or viewer. I think people who still hang on to authorial intent for dear fucking life are missing the whole point of why we enjoy works of fiction in the first place. But what do I know? I'm just some guy on YouTube who makes videos for fun. But I can tell you for a goddamn fact that whatever meaning you derive from this video is as real as you want it to be. Anyway, I'm Spike Robot. I hope you found this video fascinating, and if you liked it, and if you did, by all means, subscribe. Take it easy. Honor the Freedom Jingos.